请会众竖立。
Let's all rise.
让我们一起来唱善意颂。
Let's all sing the doxology.Please be seated.
BCMC 的家人们，大家主里平安。
Peace be unto you, to BCMC family.
平安。OK, 好。Sorry. 配合今天这个青年主日 Youth Sunday, 我很荣幸能够站在台上来跟代表青年团站在台上来跟大家分享一下这个BCMYF 这个事工。
So in conjunction to the Youth Sunday, I'm very honored to be here today to in representation of MYF to share with you our ministry.
那大家可能知道 MYF 的存在，但是可能不知道MYF 每个星期都在干嘛。
So all we may know about the existence of MYF, but not quite sure what we are doing.
Yeah. So 今天我就会在这边来跟大家做一个介绍。
So today I'll be here to introduce MYF, BC MYF to you.
OK, 下面要跟大家来介绍我们MYF 今年的这个主题与方向。
So first, we're going to introduce the this year's theme and direction.
OK, 好，所以我们今年的这个主题就是回家 homecoming.
Yeah, so first, this year's theme is homecoming.
Okay, 因为在过去的两年里面因着疫情的关系我们只能透过线上来聚会。
Because in the past 2 years, because of the pandemic, we can only do gatherings online.
所以除了每个星期六的线上聚会以外团员之间在平常的时候几乎都没有任何的这个互动。
So because of that, aside from the Saturday online meetings,Usually, we don't really have much of the interactions between members of MYF.
每个人都各自过各的生活，然后彼此都不知道对方的生活中在发生什么事情。
Everyone's living their own lives. They have no clue what other people's lives are, how they're doing.
所以这导致团员之间的关系越来越疏远。
So this caused like a segregation or a separation between the members.
每个星期的参与人数也大幅度的减少。
The attendee, the weekly attendee is also decreasing.
疫情前我们差不多每一次聚会都有十多、二十多人，但是转为线上的时候，我们的人数直接掉到少过十人。
So before the pandemic, the usual attendance is around 10 to 20 people, but since the pandemic started, the average attendee has dropped to below 10, sometimes below 10.
团员们的这个参与度也越来越低，很多在参与团契的时候，他们都不愿意把这个摄像头打开。
The participation is also not that great. Sometimes they usually don't turn on their videos.
Yeah, 所以他们只选择感兴趣的节目参加，那些他们不感兴趣的，他们就没有出现。
Yeah, some will choose interesting topics to join. Those that doesn't interest them, then they won't show up.
那这种种种现象的背后的原因呢，就是这些团员他们缺乏对 MYF 的这个所有权 ownership。
Yeah, so the cause of all these occurrence is usually because they have a lack of ownership of MYF.
他们没有把 MYF 看成是自己的家，当成是自己的家人。或许对他们来说，他们只是一个参与者而已。
They don't see MYF as their home or as their family. They just see it as they are just a participant.
所以他们就不会去看重，然后也不会关心 MYF 发生了什么事情，然后情况怎么样。
So they don't really emphasize too much on MYF. They don't really care too much of what happens in MYF and what happens afterwards.
我们之所以定下回家这个主题呢，就是想要邀请，然后带领这些已经迷失的，在外面独自漂泊很久的这些团员们，重新回到这个团契这个家当中。
So the reason for this theme is to invite and to call back those who have been wandering, those who have been lost outside, to come back to our home.
那这就是我们的目标。
So this is our objective.
Okay, 因此我们定下了三个大方向来帮助我们达成这个目标。
So we have three major directions in order to achieve this goal.
那第一个大方向就是建立团员对青年团的归属感与所有权。
So the first one is to build up the members' ownership towards MYF.
MYF 是属于每一个人的，所以大家都应该去关心和爱护这个家。
So MYF belongs to everyone, and everyone should care and love our home.
那么第二个大方向就是帮助团员与神还有其他弟兄姐妹连接。
So the second objective is to help the members, the brothers and sisters, to connect with each other and to connect with God.
我们要重新建立弟兄姐妹之间，还有个人与神之间那种密切的关系。
So we build and reestablish the closeness between each members and with God.
那第三个大方向呢，就是鼓励团员进入人群，造福社区。
And the third one is to encourage our members to go out into society and to just spread the gospel and to just go into the communities.
那这是耶稣给我们的大使命，就是要将这个福音广传，使万民做主的门徒。
Yeah, this is a great mission from our Lord Jesus, and to go and spread the gospel and to make disciples of the citizens.
那我们今年所有的节目呢，都是根据这三个大方向在做安排的。
So our programs are catered towards these three major directions.
Okay, 接下来要跟大家介绍一下青年团的委员。
All right, the next up will be going to introduce our committee.
那团长就是周勋呢。
So、
然后副团长是文健。
So president will be 周勋 and vice president will be Mankin.
Yeah, 然后这个文书是 Jovi, 财政是 Mabel.
So secretary is Jovi and treasurer is Mabel.
然后这个门训组是诗莹，宣教组是明宏。
Discipleship is Zing and outreach is Ming Hong.
门训组的目的是要帮助青年培养坚强的基督教信仰和生活。
So the reason for a discipleship is to build and to reaffirm a Christian life and their foundations.
那么宣教组就是要帮助青年认识教会的宣教使命和应该负起的责任，然后推动这个宣教的工作。
So for outreach is to make aware and to let our youth understand our mission in outreach and our responsibility in this movement.
然后接下来是这个服侍主，就是子恒弟兄，然后敬拜与团契，就是凯俊。
So service is Eric, and worship and fellowship is 凯俊。
那服侍主就是帮助青年了解社会的各种需要，然后去推动这个社会服务工作。
So service is to help them understand the needs of the society and the community, and to push for that movement.
Okay, 接下来就是还有 ，sorry， 忘记两位重量级人物。
So we kind of forgot about the two big shows here.
那这两位就是青年团的顾问，就是艾琳传道还有明辉牧师。
So our advisors, Eileen and Reverend Peter.
那我们经常有什么事情，我们就会去找他们两位去为我们指点迷津。
So of course, if we have anything, we always go reach out to them to for guidance.
Yeah. 所以接下来我们一起来看一下，为大家来介绍我们MYF 的一些节目。
So next up, we'll be introducing our programs.
那我们已经在今年四月尾的时候恢复了实体聚会。
So at the end of April, we've already come back to physical gatherings and physical worship.
但是我们依然保留这个线上的 Zoom meeting 给需要的团员。
But we still keep the online Zoom meetings just so that for those who are in need to join us through online.
所以我们现在走的是一个 hybrid 的聚会模式。
So it's a hybrid model.
Okay. 然后所以我们是有一个固定的节目的。
So we do have a fixed program.
每个月我们都会有一些的节目，像比如这个 Jesus Real Ministry 效法耶稣的服事这本书的分享，然后 video sharing 还有 connect group。
So for instance, the Jesus Driven Ministry series and video sharing as well as connect group.
那么这个 Jesus Driven Ministry 的 book sharing 呢，就是由 committee 轮流负责。
So the Jesus Driven Ministry is in charge by a rotation of the committees.
那透过这本书，我们就主要学习关于耶稣他持久侍奉的秘诀和他的生活方式。
So through this book, we can learn about the secrets of Jesus' ministry and his lifestyle.
让我们能够对我们的属灵生命还有侍奉方面做出许多的反思还有调整。
To help us reflect and to readjust our own spiritual life and our own attitude towards serving.
要帮助我们成为一名忠心侍奉神的人。
To help us be a more dedicated server.
那 video sharing 呢，就是由这个 MYF 来轮流负责。
So for video sharing is in charge by rotating members.
那我们有为 video sharing 定下一个主题，就是基督徒生活当中的优先次序。
So the theme for our video sharing is the priorities of a Christian life.
然后我们有围绕这几个课题，就是包括职场、金钱、侍奉、学业。
So the couple topics that we revolve around is workplace, finance, serving and academics.
那负责人就会去找符合主题的 video， 然后这个负责人他会看了之后，然后会准备在这个团契中来分享。
So the person in charge will find videos accordingly, and after watching, they will come back to MYF and share with the rest of us.
然后第三个 connect group 就是让它是一个平台，让这个团员们能够分享各自的近况，无论是生活上还是属灵上。
So next up is the connect group. It's a platform that allows us to really go deep and to share about our lives, no matter normal lives or spiritual lives.
然后就为着彼此的需要来代祷。
And we pray for each other's needs.
这样就可以促进团员之间有更深入的这个连接。
Which deepens the connection between members.
所以这三个就是每个月一次。然后接下来 Eileen 的 sharing series, Your True vs. The Truth, 就是会两个月一次这样子。
So the next up is, so the first three is the constant one, and then we also have Eileen sharing series, Your Truth versus the Truth.
那我们这个 Eileen 的 sharing series， 我们就会收集团员他们有关于这个关系方面的一些提问，比如讲两性关系啊，或者是与神的关系，然后 Eileen 就会在她的分享当中按照圣经的教导来回答这些的问题。
So first we will gather as much questions in relation to relationships, no matter if it's relationship with each other or relationship with God. And then Eileen will share based on the biblical principles as well as to answer the questions that they pose through biblical principles.
那在每一次在负责人他们分享完之后呢，我们就会有分到小组去讨论，去讨论分享的时候。
So after each sharing, they usually will spread into smaller groups to give input.
那负责人就会准备一些问题去让团员进行分享。
So each group will have a person in charge to set, have a set of questions for more reflection and to engage in back and forth.
因为我们要确保团员不单单有输入 input 的时候，他们也是有 output 的时候。
Yeah, we just need to, because we also need to make sure that there's not just input that's coming in, but also output that's shared out.
同时提供机会给团员之间有更多的互动。
Which also gives rise to much more opportunities for members to connect with each other.
那最后这个 special event 呢，就是会一个 quarter 就是3个月一次这样子。
So we also have special events per quarter, so every 3 months.
那我们 special event 呢，我们就会可能有一些比较特别的活动啊，像是 敬拜赞美祷告会啊 ，movie night 啊这样子。
So usually for special events, we have praise and worship meet, praise and worship prayer meetings, or special guest sharings, and also movie nights.
那大家可以看到，这个我们目前的节目呢，它大部分都还是主要还是分享的性质为主。
So the nature of most of our programs are sharing based.
所以我们希望在未来能够有更多元丰富的节目。
So we hope that in the future we have more exciting and more fulfilling programs.
比如可以学习一些新的技能的一些 workshop 啊，然后或者是甚至一起做运动啊，然后这样等等。
Like technical workshops or workouts or so and so.
Okay, so 刚刚前面我们有提到其中一个大方向，就是我们要鼓励团员进入人群，造福社区。
So before this, we mentioned a one of our big directions is to go into the communities and go into our society.
那么感谢神呢，我们在上个星期六就有这个机会到这个 Oran Asli 那边去跟他们一起庆祝校庆节。So
praise God that last week, last Saturday, we had this opportunity to go into our Oran Asli community and to celebrate Parents' Day.
在他们当中来服侍。To
serve them.
我们已经很久没有去 Oran Asli 那边了，大概将近2年到3年都有，所以 我们今年就终于有机会可以过去了。
It's been almost 2 to 3 years that since we last went went back to Oran Asli because of the pandemic. So it's this year we finally are able to go back.
那 我们都有一个 美好的一个时光在那边。
It was a really good time.
Yeah. 所以 然后接下来 我们在这个九月的时候会有这个一个短宣。So
coming up in September, we have a short mission trip.
那这次的短宣呢，我们会跟这个丹中18 CMC 我们会联办一个营会。So
we will be collaborating with 丹中18 CMC to make a camp.
Yeah, 所以这个营会呢是一个品格塑造的营会。So
it's a character development camp.
所以我们的对象是四年级到 Form 1的学生。So
our target is students in Standard 4 to Form
1。然后 这些学生呢，他们其实可以讲，基本上是全部都是 非信徒背景，然后他们可能都是第一次接触到这个信仰这样子的。So
most of the kids are non-believers, or they might be a first timer in exposing to Christian camps or this kind of sorts of programs.
所以我们会在 9月16号到18号的时候去到Jelebu卫理公会这边。
So we'll be in September 16 to 18 at Jelebu Methodist Church.
OK, Okay, 所以目前这个筹备工作在如火如荼进行中，请弟兄姐妹们在祷告中纪念。
So the preparation is in full swing. So I ask for the members' prayer for our mission.
那最后呢，我就要在这边做出邀请。
So lastly, I want to give out an invitation.
如果你是介于18岁到35岁的青年男女
，If you are individual of 18 to 35 years old.
我们都欢迎你来参与我们的团契。
We welcome you to join our fellowship.
那我们的聚会时间呢是每个星期六晚上8:30在 U Hall.
So our timing is every Saturday at 8:00 at U Hall.
那如果你想要了解更多详情，你可以来找我，或者如果你要找牧师也可以。
So if you need more details or information, you can find me and also Pastor for more information.
那我的分享就到这边，谢谢大家。
So that's our sharing for today. Thank you.
Yeah, good morning, church.
教会早安。
We want to just welcome everyone back to the house of God again.
我们要欢迎各位回来到神的家中。
This morning we have a newcomer among amidst.
好，今天我们有一位新朋友在我们当中。
His name is Alvin.
他的名字是 Alvin， 我们欢迎他。
Shall we welcome him? And please be seated. Okay, we also want to welcome for those who have not been joining us for quite some time. I do see that there are many people who came back today.
好，我们也要欢迎很久没有在我们当中的。我们看到有可能有一些也回来到参加我们当中。
Yeah, shall we just look around, maybe wave to them? Okay.Upstairs waving. All right, and also we want to welcome Auntie Chae Lim's sister's family who is in our midst today as well.
好，我们也要欢迎翠玲姐妹妹的一家人在我们当中。
Yep. All right. Okay. So I have two additional announcements.
好，这里有两项报告事项。
As we can see, in the beginning of the service, it says that MIF is resuming their physical worship.
好，刚刚我们都看到，这个少年团契将会恢复他们的实体聚会。
And it's starting from August 7 onwards.
从八月七号开始。
So I want to encourage, teenagers to join, if you can.
我们要鼓励少年人，如果你们可以的话，尽量参与。
Yeah, I believe that most of us have already went back to school physically, right? So as the fellowship is resuming physically, we also want to welcome you to join us.
我相信多数的学生都已经回学校了，所以我们这个少年团契恢复实体聚会的时候，我们也鼓励你们来参与。
And our church Bible quiz has been ongoing for 2 days.
教会的这个圣经比赛已经开始了两天。
Yeah, we want to encourage everyone to, just participate. All right, the closing is today.
我们也要鼓励大家踊跃的参与今天是最后一天哦。
Okay, so let us pray to God before we begin to receive His words into our hearts.
好，让我们在还没有领受上帝的话语前来做一个祷告。
Father Lord, it's an honor to have your presence with us this morning.
天父，我们荣幸因为你在我们的当中。
Take away all the worries and fears in this place.
请你把我们的忧虑和恐惧都挪去。
Expose all the lies which the devil has over our lives.
拆毁魔鬼在我们生命当中的谎言。
Meet us where we are right now, and may we experience the power of your word.
求你现在来与我们见面，并且让我们经历你话语的大能。
May you be magnified and exalted.
愿你被尊崇和被高举。
And in Jesus' name we pray.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen. Amen. All right, the title of my sharing this morning is Let's Fellowship.
我今早分享的主题是一起团契吧。
Yeah, this sharing is not only meant for the youth, even though today is Youth Sunday.
虽然今天是青年主日，但是这个分享并不只是给青年人。
Now, whenever the word fellowship is mentioned, we only think about the ministries of the church, like MIF, MYF, some churches even have a Methodist Adult Fellowship, Methodist Women Fellowship, Methodist Senior Fellowship, or Cell Group.
每当团契这个词出现的时候，我们可能只会想起教会当中的团契，比如说少年团契、青年团契、成年团契、妇女会，或者有些教会有乐龄团契，又或者是小组。
Now, but I pray this morning God will reveal to us His heart for the church in understanding His intended meaning of what fellowship is.
我盼望今天早上神会向我们显明他的心意， 一起来明白神对团契真正的意思。
Yeah, today the world is paying more attention to personal health. Would you agree with me?
如今的社会都非常关注自己的健康，你同意吗？
Now, there were so many aspects of wellness that we should be aware of, and we could see the advancement of technology has helped us to spread the awareness around.
有很多方面的健康是我们应该注意的。我们也可以看到科技的发达帮助我们把这个意识传达给身边的人。
Yeah, and from this image, we could see that there are 8 aspects of wellness.
好，在这个图片中呢，我们可以看到一共有8种健康的维度。
We have emotional wellness, spiritual wellness, intellectual wellness, physical wellness, environmental wellness, financial wellness, occupational wellness, and social wellness.
好，分别是情绪、心灵、智力、生理、环境、财务、职业和社群。
Yeah, it is inarguable that we spend a lot of time, effort, and money on being healthy.
无可否认的，我们都会在我们的健康上花很多的时间、精力和钱。
Yeah, we take the time to exercise, you know, work out at the gym, watch our diet, learn more about nutrition, and get enough sleep in order to achieve physical wellness.
我们会去运动、去健身、有健康的饮食，或者去学习营养学。有足够的睡眠来维持我们身体上的健康。
And intellectual wellness is achieved when we pick up some hobbies.
智力的健康呢，就是当我们去开始某一些的爱好。
A lot of us today would pay money, the money to be able to eat in comfortable and relaxing atmospheres at like cafes or restaurants, yeah, for the sake of our environmental wellness.
我们都会选择去舒服又美丽的餐厅来吃晚餐。为了就是要维持我们的环境健康。
We're willing to spend some time to attend some courses and read books on investment because we want good financial wellness.
我们都愿意花时间去参加一些讲座，或者是读一些关于投资的书，来，因为我们想要这个财务的健康。
And when we are able to have strong connections and relationship with others, we feel that our social and emotional wellness are well maintained.
好，当我们跟别人有一个良好的关系的时候，我们就觉得我们的社交和情绪的健康都维持得很好。
Yeah, striving to please our bosses at work, we are willing to allocate more time and energy to succeed in our department, which will lead to good occupational wellness.
为了要让老板开心呢，我们愿意花更多的时间在工作上，这样我们就会有职业的健康。
So I've touched about 7 wellness here, but what about our spiritual wellness?
我们已经讲到了七种的这个健康的维度，那么我们的心灵健康又如何呢？
Now, is it attained just by attending church every Sunday?
只是每个星期来教会就可以实现吗？
Now, for a Christian to be spiritually healthy, one must participate in these three: worship, service, fellowship.
基督徒如果要心灵的健康，就必须要参加这三样，就是敬拜、服事和团契。
Worship is referred to the activities of the congregation which we come together on Sunday morning, like what we are doing right now.
敬拜呢，就是指平时我们在崇拜当中所进行的活动，好像比如说现在。
Yeah, we worship God through singing and listening to the teaching of His word.
我们透过唱歌和听神的话语来敬拜他。
Now, these two are important, but a good worship experience cannot be the only aspect of church life.It is the addition of service and fellowship that makes it a church.
两个都很重要，但是一个良好的敬拜经历不能成为我们在教会生活里面唯一的方面，必须要有服事和团契来完成一个教会。
So service is the acts that are done within and outside of the church body to minister to specific needs.
服事呢，是指在教会内和外所做的行动，特别是像有需要的人。
Now, an example of service within the body would be like teaching kids alive or greeting and ushering people, you know, when they come to church.
在教会里面服事的其中一些例子，就是可能在主日学做教导，又或者是在崇拜做招待员。
And if service outside the body would be typified by short-term missions or providing meals to people, yeah, for those who need physical needs.
在教会外服事的象征就是参加短宣或者派食物给有需要的人。
Now, if we have service alone, but without worship, it's actually equal to a charitable organization. It's not a true church.
服事本身如果没有敬拜，那就只是一个行善的组织，而不是一个教会。
Okay, then fellowship. Fellowship is when the members of the body share life together.
团契呢，就是当教会的会友一起分享生命。
And when the church group start to feel like a true fellowship, right? It's like when a true church start to feel like a family, it is gearing towards true fellowship.
当教会的群体开始有家人的感觉，那就是迈向真正团契的象征。
However, if you only join fellowship but not worship and service, this is only a clique, not a church.
然而，如果团契没有敬拜和服事，那只是一个党派，而不是一个教会。
Yeah, as we see, we need all these three: worship, service, and fellowship. So, what happens when one side is weakened?
我们看到这三样都很重要。那么，当如果其中一方弱了，会发生什么事情？
Now, if we are only coming together, not coming together for singing, praying, and teaching, but only serving and attending fellowship, then the church body will be fragmented and struggle to find unity.
当我们没有聚在一起唱诗、祷告、教导，而只是服事和参加团契，那么教会就会破裂，并且不合一。
Yeah, good fellowship with others may be built, but it will not be centered around a common view for what God is doing in the church today.
良好的关系还是可以被建立起来，但是并不会有共同的看见，也不会以神的计划为中心。
And if we are worshiping and serving without real fellowship, then the members of the body will transition from feeling unappreciated to feeling used.
如果我们的敬拜和服事少了真正的团契，那么我们就会从不被感激演变成觉得我们自己被利用。
Yeah, because people will, you know, just come to worship and they will serve and serve, but they do not have true fellowship. That's when they will feel unappreciated.
就是当人来一直来服事的时候，可是没有跟别人有良好的关系，就会觉得哎，我没有被感激，一直被利用。
They will come and then drift away from church because they do not find the interaction that should typify what a true church is.
当人找不到他们认为教会应该有的互动的时候，他们就会溜走了。
Now, in my experience of being here in Banting for more than 5 years, it is the fellowship leg of the triangle that seems to suffer the most.
根据我在万金超过五年的经验，在这个三角形当中，其实是团契的这个角是挣扎最多的。
We have more than 100 attendance weekly, you know, joining worship physically and virtually.
我们每个星期都有几百的人参加崇拜，无论是线上的还是实体的。
We have members serving on a weekly basis to keep programs and activities running in the church.
我们的会友每个星期都服事，为了就是教会里的活动可以每个星期都运作。
But fellowship is a different story.
但是团契是不同的。
We often hear people talking about fellowship.
我们常常会听到别人讨论关于团契。
We hear it is said that what we need is more fellowship.
我们听到他们说，哦，我们需要的是更多的团契。
But our modern ideas of fellowship have been so watered down that the word no longer carries the same meaning it did in the New Testament's time.
但是我们今天对团契的这概念已经被浅化了。我们正所谓的团契已经跟圣经新约里面的意思不一样了。
Now, we're not surprised that the early church devoted itself to the apostles' teaching and also to prayer.
我们不会觉得惊讶，当我们知道早期的教会委身自己在门徒的教导和祷告。
Apart from the ministry of the Holy Spirit, these are the two most important means of growth, power, and effectiveness in the Christian life. And this is everywhere evident in the rest of the scripture.
除了圣灵的教导，这两个是对成长能力和有效的基督徒生活里面最重要的意义，我们可以在经文其他部分可以看到。
But Luke tells us that these early Christians also devoted themselves to fellowship. They just didn't have fellowship. They devoted themselves to it.
但是路加告诉我们，早期的基督徒也把自己委身在团契。他们不只是有团契，他们把自己也委身进去里面团契。
Yeah, this means that fellowship was a priority, and it was also one of the objectives for gathering together. They made fellowship a priority.
这代表着团契是聚在一起的优先次序，他们把团契放在首要的次序。
Yeah, right now let's just watch a video sharing from our brother Qi Liang, who has found the importance of fellowship in his life so much so that he makes it a priority to attend it weekly.
让我们来看一个影片，关于我们的启亮弟兄找到了参加团契的重要性，而且每个星期他都会播出时间来出席。
多谢团契给予我这个机会分享。大家好，我是启亮，目前去了国宾参加教会年度集会，所以透过这里穿越时空来分享。我在一个非基督徒背景的家庭长大，由于父亲的职业，所以我的童年小学期和中学期都没有固定在一个地方，最短就有几个月搬家，最长就有三年搬家一次。整个马来西亚我们都有暂住过，除了沙巴也有一年各在新加坡和文莱逗留过，我们一家可以用游牧一词来形容。但是我在我专攻硕士学位时就开始定居在班定这里。大学时期尾端，我在冈巴念书时就被免费的晚餐引诱到 Alpha 认识耶稣。毕业后也就是 MCO 开始的2020年，回去和父母一起住在班定，直到圣灵在2022年3月尾端引导我到 BCMC 参加 MYF。 我参加的团契有两个，冈巴 Life Church 的细胞小组 Dulos 和万金卫理公会的 MYF， 两者都大同小异，每个会员都放下身份参与，就好像回到家感一样。平时参加一般的社交活动都感觉到特别的格格不入，但是团契的热忱溶解了这个感觉，变成每个活动都特别的愉快。结果每个星期都特别期待下一个活动是什么，然后就主动报名参加。假如那天和我工作时间摩擦的话，我都会特地请假来参加团契活动，理所当然的工钱也照样被扣了。我没有后悔过这个选择，因为在《使徒行传》第一章第八节，但圣灵降临在于你们身上，你们就必得能力，并要在耶路撒冷、犹太全地和撒玛利亚直到地极做我见证。就像保罗般，虽然身上有份制作帐篷的工作，但是主要目的还是鼓励和协助其他人继续为耶稣之名带来荣耀和见证。团契曾经有个探索人生目标的主题，经过小组讨论后和祈祷后，才发现自己在尚未跟随耶稣前，天父就已在隐隐约约地关照我了。还记得那时跟随耶稣前的我是个十分抗拒立基督徒的人，认为神只是一个傲慢不关怀，把人们当成是个移动的肉袋子的超自然体。但是天父并没有将我抛弃，天父时时刻刻在暗中引导我到下一个目的地，由此赐给我了一个几乎没有存在感危机和迷惑感的成长期。回想起来，那时候我几乎每一刻都有目标，从小学到大学到认识耶稣直到今天，还有很多见证和故事希望以后可以和大家分享。祝大家和天父一起的旅程中稳定的成长，谢谢大家。
Yeah, we could see Brother Qi Liang really devoted his time to fellowship.
我们可以看到启良弟兄真的是把他的时间就是委身在团契。
Today, however, we often view fellowship as what we do in makan-makan gatherings.
好，然而今天我们会时常看团契，就只是来聚一聚，来一起吃喝。
It's where we have casual conversations and savor coffee, kueh.
就是我们谈天、喝咖啡、吃糕点的地方。
But this is not bad and can actually contribute to fellowship. You know, food is very important, right? But it falls far short of fellowship according to biblical standard and according to the meaning and use of the Greek words for fellowship.
这不是一件坏事，也含有这个团契的意思。食物吃喝很重要，哎，但是离圣经当中，希腊文团契的意思还相差很远。
Now the word fellowship comes from the Greek word koinonia, And in the New Testament, it often denotes to sharing, close association, or mutual participation.
这个词团契来自于希腊文 koinonia， 在新约当中常常会翻译成分享、紧密的联合或者相互参与。
Now, when the Bible talks about fellowship, we can observe three senses.
当圣经中提到团契，我们可以观察到至少三个观念。
Firstly, fellowship is a shared life from Jesus.
好，第一就是从耶稣里分享生命。
The First Corinthians it says, God is faithful through you whom you were called into fellowship with His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord.
在哥林多前书一章九节，神是信实的，你们原是被他造的。好与他儿子我们的主耶稣基督一同得分。
Now, sometimes the word fellowship is used to explain the bond between believers and the Lord.
有时候团契这个词是用来形容信徒们与主耶稣基督之间的关系。
So fellowship is not just only when we say, you know, to with the church members, it's fellowship with the Lord.
团契就不只是我们member 之间的这个关系，是跟神之间的关系。
Now, it's also stated in John 15:1-11.The real Christian fellowship happens when branches, you know, we as disciples of Christ, draw life from the vine itself with Jesus.
在约翰福音十五章一到十一节中记载，真正的基督徒团契就是当枝子，就是身为基督身为门徒的我们，像葡萄树，就是耶稣本身得到生命。
But secondly, fellowship is also shared life with each other.
好，第二。团契就是与他人分享生命。
Hebrews said, "Don't forget to do good and to share with those in need. These are the sacrifices that please God."
希伯来书中说到，不可忘记行善和捐书的事，因为这样的祭是神所喜悦的。
So fellowship is not only just makan, but it also involves the way believers help one another, often in the context of meeting physical needs.
团契不只是吃喝。也包括了信徒们互相帮忙的方式，尤其是在肉体方面的需要。
Now, as much as the same way Christ supplies all our needs according to His riches, we reflect His love by supplying the same kind of love to the rest of His body.
基督必按照他的丰富来供应我们一切所需的。为了反映基督的爱，我们必须要用一样的爱来爱他的肢体。
Now, thirdly, fellowship is shared living for the same purpose.
第三就是有着同样的目的。
Now, finally, fellowship can refer to a sharing of the same purpose, right?
最后，团契就是有着同样的这个目的。
Now, all the believers were continuing devoting themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship and to sharing in meals and to prayer. And all the believers met together in one place and shared everything they had. This is what Acts talk about. Real fellowship is.
在使徒行传中有提到真正的团契就是当门徒都恒心遵守使徒的教训彼此相交掰饼祈祷信的人都在一处凡物共用。
So what we can learn from the fellowship of the early church is that they consist in unity in doctrine, belief and direction.
早期的教会在教导相信和方向中都合一。
And these three elements are joined together in the essentials of the church core identity and purpose.
教会主要的身份和目的是需要靠这三个元素合在一起。
So why is fellowship much needed today?
为什么今天的团契被需要？
Now, fellowship is much needed today as a lot of Christian life is impossible to live out only on Sunday morning.
团契被需要因为多数的基督徒生命都不可能只是在星期天中活出来。
The Bible is filled with one another verses commanding believers to bear one another's burden, build one another up, confess your sins to one another, and love one another.
圣经中充满了彼此这个词，就是要命令信徒们的重担要彼此担当，彼此建立，彼此认罪，彼此相爱。
It's only as a small group of believers in a commit face time.To each other, that any of these commands can become possible.
唯有当一小组的信徒们互相见面的时候，这些命令才可能实现。
Yet this is the fellowship. This is fellowship at the heart of God's plan for us to grow.
这个 团契就会在神的计划的中心，以便我们成长。
Yeah, and through fellowship, we can see God through other people impacts our life.
透过团契，我们可以看到神透过其他人的生命来影响我们。
Yeah, undeniably, studying the Bible for yourself is crucial. Corporate worship is vital.
无可否认的，我们自己研读圣经是很重要的，参与崇拜也是非常重要的。
Yeah, but many times, I personally experience that it is the timely word of another Christian or the faith of another believer that gave me the courage that I needed to trust God in a difficult situation. I'm sure many of you will agree with me.
但是很多时候，我本身所经历到的就是透过另外一位基督徒的分享，又或者是另外一位信徒的他的信心，会给我勇气在艰难的时候来信靠神。我肯定大家都会同意我所说的。
So at this moment, I would like to invite Sister Angeline to share with us her experience of communing with fellow believers during fellowship.
这个时候我要邀请诗婷姐妹来分享关于她在团契中和其他团员的相处经历。
各位组内的弟兄姐妹们，大家早上好，我是 Angeline。
Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. My name is Angeline.
从小我就在教会长大，然后还记得在以前很小的时候。
I grew up in church, and still remember when I was young.
我就会跟我的父母一起参与细胞小组，然后早上就会被父母带去教会崇拜。
I would join my parents' cell group, and in the morning, my parents would bring me here to church.
然后过后就会去参加主日学。
And afterwards, after the service, we'll usually join Sunday school.
过后一直到我13岁的时候，我就开始进入 MIF 这个团契。
So up until I was around 13 years old, I started joining MIF and MYF.
然后当时候我对团契的认识就是可以和一群朋友拜六礼拜能够在教会聚集。
So back then, my understanding of fellowship is just to get to hang out with my friends on a weekend.
然后分享日常，互相倾诉。
So talk about my days, to talk about life.
然后享受大家在一起的轻松氛围，轻松时光这样。
And to enjoy just being around my friends, just chilling.
Okay.然后对团契的认识就是可以跟教会的朋友们聚会跟服侍。
My understanding of a fellowship is just to be able to gather with fellow members and to serve together.
然后过后一直到我上了大学比较忙了之后。
So until I attended university when my life gets a bit busier.
我其实基本上不常出席团聚。
I haven't really been attending much of fellowship.
过后慢慢的我的心态上也有些变化。
And gradually there's a change in my attitude.
然后我对团契感到比较陌生那个时候。
I feel very distant from fellowship.
Yeah, 然后过后不知道该如何像以前一样的心态去参与。
And wasn't quite sure how I should approach fellowship back with understanding that I had before.
然后心里觉得很孤单，给自己比较多的理由不去出席团契这样。
Yeah, I was feeling loneliness in my heart and keep giving myself a lot of excuses to not attend fellowship.
过后就这样，叛逆不懂事的我一直来到新加坡实习的时候。
Up until then, the rebellious me were eventually ended up interning in Singapore.
然后除了和教会需要安排服侍的弟兄姐妹们交代之外
，So aside from communicating my service and my being in charge, is it?
Yeah. 然后其实基本上都不可没有跟一个人讲我去新加坡。
Oh, basically, I never really told much of anyone that I'm going to Singapore.
因为我觉得没有必要去分享去交代这样。
Because I didn't see the need of just of sharing or to yeah to tell anyone.
Yes, okay. 然后慢慢的在新加坡的时候，因为工作上的性质。
As I spend my time in Singapore because of the nature of my work.
然后在礼拜天要去教会变成是一件蛮难的事情。
So going to church on a Sunday became something very hard.
然后我感觉到我的心灵其实没有落脚的地方了。
I feel like my spirit don't really have a root to go back to.
然后很感谢神的安排还有怜悯。
Really thankful for the Lord's mercy and the Lord's arrangement.
Yeah, okay. 然后当时有一个基督徒同事他介绍我去参与一个聚会。
Back then, there was a Christian that invited me to the church.
而且还是在我的休息日。
And it was on my rest day, on my off day.
然后在参与的同时，我感觉到各弟兄姐妹们都放下自己的身份，这样。
And I was joining the fellowship. I can see that everyone is letting their guard down.
然后好像回到了家的感觉。
It's like I'm going. I say I'm being back home.
然后大家会互相关怀，也会互相理解，这样。
And we care for each other and to understand each other.
然后为彼此代祷，一起领受神的话语。
And to pray for each other and to receive the word of God together.
然后过我才发现，那其实身边有个团契是非常重要的事情。
Which is when I realized that is actually a very, very great thing to be a part of a fellowship.
然后因为当自己在面对外界有疑惑、跟软弱还有诱惑的时候。
And because when I'm in the community, when I'm facing temptation, when I'm facing troubles,
身边就会有弟兄姐妹会互相提醒。
A lot of the members would remind me and to encourage me.
然后会互相代祷。
Would pray for me.
然后这个时候我就发现自己以前其实还蛮不懂事的。
Which is when I realized that I actually don't really know a lot back then.
然后一直到我回来马来西亚过后。
And up until I came back to Malaysia,
我又开始回到 MYF 这个团契。
I started joining MYF again.
然后记得以前在 MYF 有个节目，然后有分享小组的环节。
And I remember there's one of the programs that I joined MYF, and there's a sharing session.
当时有一个分享的题目，我不是很想分享。
Back then there was a topic that I don't really feel like sharing.
因为其实当中是我还蛮迷茫，跟我觉得我自己那时候还蛮迷茫和软弱的事情。
Because back then, I still feel like I was still very lost and very weak.
当时我记得是艾琳姐，她鼓励了我，然后要我们学习勇敢表达自己的软弱，这样。
I remember back then it was Eileen that encouraged me to, express briefly our, weaknesses and our shortcomings.
然后我才发现，原来把问题说出来过后，心里其实踏实许多。
That's when I realized that after sharing out my problems or after sharing out my troubles, my heart became more steady.
Yeah, 然后因为大家可以一起互相理解、互相代祷。
Because everyone, we can able to understand each other better and to pray for each other.
然后也可以从中寻求帮助跟开导，这样。
And from then I can seek guidance and to seek a help.
然后团契对我来讲，现在就像一个大家庭。
Now, fellowship to me is like a big home, like a big family.
然后大家可以卸下自己的武装。
Then we can take down our armor.
然后一起把问题带去神的面前。
And bring forth our problems to the Lord.
然后可以一起互相学习。
To learn from each other.
互相勉励。
To encourage each other.
互相接纳。
And to accept each other.
虽然也有会有不愉快的时候。
Of course, there will be times that is not as fun.
但是神就是要我们在爱中包容。
But Lord, it wants us to love one another in that circumstance.
在爱中成长。
To grow in love.
我的分享就到此结束，谢谢大家。
That's all for my sharing. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Angeline.
谢谢 Angeline， 还有 Joshua。
Joshua. Yeah, God uses. Yeah, we see from her sharing that God uses other people to make His word more real to us.
神透过其他人来让他的话语更加真实。
But if we are not developing meaningful relationships with other believers, we miss out on the impact he seeks to make through them.
但是如果我们没有跟其他人有良好的关系的时候，我们就错过了神要透过他们给我们的影响。
The fellowships are also how we support and encourage one another as a church.
团契也是身为教会的我们如何互相支持和鼓励。
Yeah, meeting together in smaller groups can encourage believers in two ways.
彼此在一个小组见面呢，可以在两方面鼓励信徒们。
Now, first is somewhat obvious. We can encourage one another through times of struggle or celebrate in the good times.
第一个非常明显的就是我们可以在患难的时候 一起彼此鼓励，或者一起庆祝美好的时刻。
And we can build each other up and hold each other accountable.
我们可以彼此建立，也一起负起责任。
Now, secondly, it can get easily discouraging to remain strong in your faith when you never spend quality time around other believers.
接下来，如果我们从来不花时间跟我们身边的信徒们相处的时候，我们的信心就很难维持在一个很强的状态。
Yeah, being around other Christians reminds you that there are other sane and hopefully normal people who also makes Jesus a priority.
当我们身边都有基督徒的时候，我们就会被提醒到，哦，原来身边还有其他所谓正常的人，也把耶稣视为他们的优先次序。
It helps you to remember that you're not alone in this journey of faith.
这样会帮助你记得，在这个信仰的道路上，你是不孤单的。
So lastly, what is the one thing to remember as we fellowship?
最后有哪一件事情是我们团契的时候要记得的？
Fellowship is a gathering of imperfect disciples of Christ.
团契就是一群不完美的基督跟从者一起聚集。
That's why sometimes when we gather, we face some certain conflicts.
所以当我们见面的时候，我们就会有一些的摩擦。
FellowshipIt's a gathering of imperfect disciples of Christ, and the reason why we gather is to let the Word of God and His presence transform us as we share life together.
团契就是一群不完美的人一起聚集，是为了让神的同在和他的话语来改变我们。
Yeah, the author of Hebrews exhorts us to think of ways to motivate one another to acts of love and good works.And not to neglect our meeting together, as some people do, but encourage one another, especially now that the day of the Lord's return is drawing near.
希伯来书的作者劝告我们说，要彼此相顾，激发爱心，勉励行善，不可停止聚会，好像那些停止惯了的人，倒要彼此劝勉，既知道那日子将临近，就更当如此。
Now, when we fellowship in the name of Jesus Christ, this gives others a picture of who God is.
当我们奉耶稣的名团契的时候，就能够让别人看见神是怎样的。
Now, each of us together shows all of God's graces to the world.
当我们全部在一起的时候，就显明了神对这个世界的恩典。
No one is perfect.
没有人是完美的。
Now, we all sin, but each of us has a purpose here on earth to show aspects of God to those around us.
我们都会犯罪，但是我们每一个人在这个世界上都有一个目的，那就是要让身边的人看到上帝。
God has given specific spiritual gifts to each one of us.
上帝都把恩赐赐给我们每一位。
And when we come together in fellowship, it's like a whole of us demonstrating who God is.
当我们在一起团契的时候，就好像我们全部合为一体的把神显示出来。
Now think of it like baking a cake.
就好像在烘焙一个蛋糕。
Now you need butter, flour, sugar, eggs, oils, you know, and more to make a cake, right?
你需要牛油、面粉、糖、鸡蛋、油，还有其他的来完成一个蛋糕。
The egg will never be the flour.
鸡蛋永远不可以代替面粉。
And none of them alone can make up a cake.
没有一种材料能够单独完成一整个蛋糕。
And yet, together, all of those ingredients make a delicious cake.
但是当所有的材料在一起的时候，就可以烘焙出一个美味的蛋糕。
Still talking about makan.
还在讲着吃哦。
Okay, so it's like that of a fellowship. All of us together show the glory of God.
团契也是如此，当我们在一起的时候，就会显明神的荣耀。
So,If you are not in the fellowship or joining a cell group, let me encourage you to make time for one starting this week.
如果你还没有参加任何一个团契或者小组，让我来鼓励你，从这个星期开始安排时间去参与。
We have fellowships and cell groups weekly in our church.
我们每个星期都会有团契和小组。
Not in our church here. I mean, like you know, some are in some cell group leaders' houses.
不只是在教会里面还有一些小组是在组长的家。
And I pray that the Holy Spirit will stir your hearts to step out in courage and faith to prioritize, devote your time to God and the members of the body.
但愿圣灵感动你的心，带着勇敢踏出第一步，把你的时间分别为圣的给神和他的肢体。
And I pray that you won't miss out on these vital means for your spiritual growth and support.
我向神祷告，你将不会错过这个能够让你属灵成长的机会。
As we can see, three elements are very important: worship, service, and fellowship.
我们可以看到三个元素是很重要的：敬拜、服事和团契。
And as we worship right now, let us once again commit our hearts to God.
当我们敬拜的时候，我们把我们的心再次的献上给神。
We use this song to remember what Jesus has done for us, and let us also supply His love to the fellowship.
我们要记得，神是怎样的爱我们，我们也要把这份爱传达给身边的人。让我们来领受上帝的恩典。
May Jesus Christ dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in God's love, may have the power to understand how wide, how long, how high, and how deep His love is.
但愿因你们的信，耶稣基督住在你们心里，叫你们的爱心有根有基，能明基督的爱是何等长阔高深。
And may you experience the love of Christ that surpasses all knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of life and power that comes from God.
并知道这爱是过于人能所测度的，便叫神一切所充满的充满了你们。
And together as a church, we say,
Amen.
All right, please be seated.
请坐。
We'll see you next week.
我下个礼拜见。